Good evening, short story writers, and okay, so two things. First, this is the last Saturday one I'm going to do for a while because Christmas season's coming up and Saturdays get to be a bit important, in my calendar at least. And the other thing is that it's the last in the rubbish series. And the initial idea that triggered all this was... you know, things pop into your head every now and again, and oh yeah, I remember that. Somebody had apparently gone through Bob Dylan's trash, rubbish, garbage to see if he'd thrown away any kind of notes. This must have been an Uber fan. Or maybe they thought, well, I'll be able to sell these at auction or something. But for whatever reason, they were going through his rubbish. So there's that. There's also the really rich colleges in America, Harvard and Princeton, I think, and Yale are the three that I can remember. And I know they call them the Ivy League or something. They're equivalent of Cambridge and Oxford and Durham. And here in England, if you are not from the UK. And then there'd be, is it St. Andrews in Scotland? And I don't know the name of the one in Dublin. But they've got the Book of Kells there. Anyway, every year, students who've been in residence there just chuck stuff away. So people go into the big, they call them dumpsters there. We call them skips. And they pull out like, TVs and computers and things that the students no longer want. So that'd be idea number one. Your main character is somebody who has a serious hobby, or perhaps they do it and sell it on eBay, but they go what in America is called dumpster diving. You know, they just go through skips and things. Secondly, it could be somebody who stalks some sort of celebrities' rubbish to find out what they're throwing out, maybe for nefarious purposes, so they can find out things about them and then do horrible things like burgle them. Or it could be that they want to sell the stuff on eBay or wherever, an auction it, or maybe they're just a super fan and they want their heroes scribblings or castoffs or whatever it is that motivates these people. And then the third would be identity theft. So apparently this was a thing, and possibly still is a thing. People were going, they were getting rubbish from the roadside, and they were ripping it open and looking for receipts and things so they could perform identity theft. So there's three ideas. They're all problems in their own way. And as usual, this is something that's happening in life. So I probably, if you want to write literary fiction, you probably got a better idea what you could do with this than I could. But it could be that somebody does have their identity stolen or their original creative work stolen and they have to go to court over it. Horror, science fiction and science fantasy. It could be some budding Einstein and his ideas or her ideas are stolen or its ideas. I mean, why not AI? There's an idea for science fiction, and also it could be science fantasy. And AI acquires kind of person status because why not? Limited companies are persons. So if an AI set itself up as a limited company in order to do trade, then technically it would be a person, and therefore it would have certain rights in law. I've just thought that up, but feel free to take that and run with it and write a story around it. And also, maybe if an AI could do it, then a malevolent spirit could do it in a horror story. I mean, why is it when we see horror stories, it's always they've got to go into some environment like a monastery or whatever, and then ghosts come and try and eat them. Why is it that the ghosts can't behave a bit more like horrible human beings do? You know, the ones that were selling fuel to Nazi Germany until 1943. I wonder who that could have been. Until they got patriotic because they realised that the war was being lost, and therefore maybe it wouldn't look so good on them if their own servicemen from their own country were being bombed for longer than was necessary. And I'm just throwing this out there, you know. It's documented fact. It's there, you can research it. And then action thriller, same thing. Somebody who's a spy has to do this in order to impersonate somebody. Mission Impossible style, perhaps. And or to auction it, and they find themselves in trouble. And or the amazing stuff being thrown out, that could be that they find themselves in possession of something which shouldn't have been in the dumpster, and they find themselves in big trouble because of that. The law that's levied at them is that technically going into those dumpsters is a crime. All right, 6:27. So do with that what you will. The way to do these things is to, this is it, let's do some what ifs on it. What if it were bigger? What if it were smaller? What if it were wider? What if it were heavier? What if it were lighter? What is it meant to be? It's a dumpster. Imagine a dumpster. I'm going to use that word rather than a skip, because skip sounds like exercise, doesn't it? Which technically this is. And it's meant to hold rubbish. So then Edward de Bono would say, well, okay, you have to start with the idea that skips do not hold rubbish. They are for the opposite. They hold precious things, or they don't hold anything at all, or rubbish is put around them and they are left hollow. Start with that kind of thing and think, well, what would the purpose of that be? And then you can end up with some jolly good ideas, as Edward de Bono and several of his students have over the years. All right, now we're at 7:26. So it's time for me to say, as usual, if this was good, give it a thumbs up. If it's useful, if it's a load of old nonsense, thumbs down. And until next time, happy writing.